Welcome to Solopreneur Success Strategies, where we talk about the entrepreneurial mindset and how to get your message out to your customers, how to know what your customer wants, and how to make them your raving fans, as well as the knowledge and skills you need as an entrepreneur to save you time, money, and be more productive in your business. So welcome. Welcome. This is Jane Gardner, and this is Solopreneur Success Strategies. And today we're purple, so that means it's Strategy Sunday. Sorry for those on the audio. I meant my background is purple. And welcome. To those of you who don't know me, I'm Jane Gardner, and I work with my husband in our home business structural engineering firm for the last 20 years. And about 3 years ago, I decided I would go out and try and help other people to start their own business on the internet. But let's go and have a look. We're talking about strategy today. And this is Strategy Sunday because I thought this is a good day to start looking at your vision and your goals for your business and maybe change your strategy if you feel you need to occasionally. So it's good to know how to first design your strategy. So we were looking at previously your goals and vision for your lifestyle business. What do you want to do for your lifestyle business? How many hours do you want to spend on your business? What is your goals for your lifestyle business? What is the revenue that you want for your business? We had a look at if you wanted to say $100,000 in a year, that you would have to make about $8,000 a month, in order to get $100,000 for the year. For example, we worked on some math, I think. And then we looked at some model of a business that you could maybe do that would get diverse forms of revenue into your business so that you could get that kind of revenue. But anyway, today we're going to be talking about some of the business models and seeing some of the pros and cons of the various business models that I just picked out that might be work on the internet. Certainly I could talk about the ones offline as well, but today we're going to be talking about the online business models. So let's go have a look at what our overview is for Strategy Sunday. We've talked about the vision for you and your business. We gave you some worksheets so you could look at your five-year goal, your three-year goal, and your one-year goal. You always look at the end result or the outcome for your goals and then work backwards from there in terms of your goals. And so we're going to be starting looking at you and your business plan. We've already started having a look at how to work on that. But your business is like a stream. It flows, it can trickle, it can change direction, it can surge, it can get blocked, but it can never go back in time. So always move forward and you'll always be moving forward in your business. And if you want to come and see the video, for those of you on audio, you go to jgtips.com/ssunday, and that will have the current show for Strategy Sunday, as well if you'd like to see the other shows, which include Mindset Monday, Get Your Message Out Tuesday, World Domination Wednesday, which is about your customers, Jill or Jack of All Trades Thursday, which is about skills and knowledge you need if you're an entrepreneur. Friday is Freebie Fridays, and Saturday is Systems Saturday, putting systems into your business so it free up your time to do more business. You can go to jgtips.com/YouTube. And I have a channel there called Solopreneur Success Strategies, which has all the shows on it. And you can go back and have a look at the previous episodes. So let's go. And as I mentioned, I love the idea of your business being like a stream. So, for now, we're looked at the vision for you and your business and your goals. You need to have goals for your business, 1 year, 3 year, and 5 year goal. If you don't have a goal, then you can't move forward in your business because you don't know what direction you're going without your small goals or your large goals. And now we're going to start talking about you and your business plan and how you should always have a plan for your business every year, and it can change easily because that's why we'll be talking some about the trends in 2016 and how they can affect your strategy in the coming years. So let's have a look. We had a look at looking at a financial goal. If you had a one-year goal of $100,000 in a year, to make that goal, you would need to make about $8,333 a month, or $1,923 a week on a regular basis, or $25,000 per quarter. We also had a look at the sources. If you decided you wanted to have a look at, we looked at briefly some of the, if you wanted to make $1 million in a year, $500,000 a year, and $250,000 in a year, what you would need to make per month in order to do that, or how many items at $100 you would have to sell. So let's look at the extreme for that. If you wanted to make $1 million for the year, if you wanted, you would need $83,000 a month. And in order to get $83,000 a month, you would have to sell 830 $100 items, or 160 $500 items a month, or 84 $1,000 items per month. So, of course, if you had those as three different types of revenue, $100, $500, and $1,000 item, then if you combined and were lucky enough to get all three of them going in the month and selling that many that I mentioned, you could make $275,000 a month, which, of course, is more than $1 million a year. So the conclusion we made from that is that it is always best to have a diverse business model. Whatever type of business you have, don't be dependent on only one product. If you can have, for example, a small item to get your customers in that is at a lower end price, and then you will have more people come in on that price, and then you can increase the price of your various products and services that you have. You'll have less clients at the higher end, but you will certainly be making money because you'll have a diverse business model. So I think there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 levels of revenue coming in, and on a consistent basis, you will have a good income. So I guess what I'm saying is try the diverse business model when you're thinking about forms of revenue. So anyway, what kind of business model do you envision when you look at your goals for your lifestyle business? When we were talking about a lifestyle business, we were talking about how many hours a week do you want to work on your business? And that will also determine the kind of business model that you have and the kind of business that you have and the kind of revenue that comes in. Because even though the more hours you work, you might get more income, there are business models where it makes no difference the more hours you work because of automation. But anyway, that's for another day. So today we're going to take, I mentioned some of the models, and we're going to look at briefly value-added reseller, freemium business, affiliate marketing business, online content business, an online educator business, a premium business, and coaching business, and a subscription business today, and compare the pros and cons of the various businesses. So let's, but first, of course, I better define them. So we also have direct sales. I forgot to say that. That would be selling directly to a consumer in their homes or retail, depending on what the product is, or you can do it in a retail location. This is always a one-on-one. It's never a group. So it's always a relationship you have with a customer one-on-one. For value-added reseller, you would add value to a product and in a network, and they would also be in the network, and you would resell that product as well as they would be reselling the product as well. And so you have a network of business who are interested in selling that product. Can't think of anything at the moment other than if you decided that you wanted to, you had a, someone has a software and you have a piece of software that goes well with that software, and they decide that they're willing to have that your software incorporated into their software as a package, then of course both of you are going to be selling it. Then there's the freemium business. That's where you give away a free software and you get better benefits when the person upgrades to a paid software. For example, that would be something like Dropbox, where you can get a free storage in Dropbox for a certain level. But in order to get more storage, you have to pay for it. Affiliate marketing, where you promote others' products, who pay, and then the person pays you back a commission when you sell his product or her product. That is another type of business. Then there is the simple business, which is I call the online content business, where you sell your online products or services, which has a certain value to it, and it has it's a certain price because it's a set. A piece of content as a product. That would be something like a bookstore, for example. Online educator, where you train others in processes or ideas. That would be someone like myself who likes to educate. And then premium, that's where you sell higher perceived value products. That would be someone like BMW or a golf course, you know, membership, that kind of thing, where the perceived value makes it also have a higher price because of the perceived value, for example, of a spa, exclusivity and all that kind of stuff wrapped into it. There's coaching. You can do individual and group training privately. That can also have a certain pros and cons. And then there's a subscription business online where you have a product or service which people receive monthly, and either you increase the value of the subscription by adding new content each month. So those are some of the business models that you can have online, except for the direct sales one. It could be called direct sale. That you could call that catalogs. Probably you could use that as a catalog example. Anyway, that's not really important what the business model is. It's up to you to decide what your hours are. So let's see. I don't know if you can read this very well, but I just sort of briefly put down one pro and con for direct sales. So obviously the pro is one-on-one relationship. The con is, of course, not having enough customers, and of course the time per customer is high, and it's limited to how much time you have, unless you have something like a catalog or a bookstore online. But of course even then you need to have a certain time to it. Value added reseller, you have added value as part of a network of sellers, so of course that's the pro to it. But of course the con is, well, your customers want it as it is. So of course you have to market with others, sellers. So it's a good thing, but of course that's less, you're also sharing the profit. So there's also less time that's your time, and it's also dependent on other people. The freemium model, well, where you have a paid version with better features, that's the pro. So it is a possible to have that as a business model. But of course, you always need enough customers who will be willing to pay for it. So that's always the same as, do customers want it? And of course, you have to have marketing awareness. So you have to have a lot of time doing that marketing to create awareness for it. For affiliate marketing, you don't have to create the product. That's the pro for it. But the con is, of course, you're selling alongside others who are also competing with you to sell it. And so your profit would be less if it's something that everybody wants. And it just depends. Do people still, of course, want it? And so you need customers willing to be on your list and be marketed to by you every month with new products. And then there's online content business. The pro is, of course, it's available to buy at any time because it's online on the internet. And of course, the con is, just like for everybody else, is, well, customers want it. And you can create, in terms of time, you can create a content creation process that will reduce the time spent on it. So that's the good thing about it. If you can reduce the time needed to create, and you can just put it up and have it as a passive place for people to come and buy, then that actually means that you might have more time to either grow your business or to spend more time with your family. As an online educator, you have to be willing to teach to wide audiences, so that's the pro. Now that there's the internet, you can teach to all the world if you wish. But of course, the con is, do customers want it? Same for everything else. And of course, the time, in terms of time, you can do it live, but there's also replays. So you can just create it and then put it up on the internet to replay. The premium model, of course, is a higher return on your valued price. But is there enough customers? And of course, it's one-on-one marketing and relationships. So there's a lot of time spent on the perception of selling it to the higher end customers. Coaching, the pros to that is it's one-on-one and personal, and you can also do groups. So it's a very personal relationship. But of course, the time spent one-on-one can be basically you're spending time for your money and you can't get back time. So it limits the revenue that you can have if you do it one-on-one all the time. The subscription model, you can have a monthly revenue, but of course, does the customer want it? And of course, you always have to update the content each month. But it's also based on the time marketing and content creation time, but it is also a passive form of income. So those are some of the business models that you can do on the internet. It's up to you to decide which one you might be interested in doing. But as you can see, quite a few of them have quite different issues with them. As I didn't put anything of the other models on there because I didn't really want to talk about network marketing or multi-level marketing at this time. So what kind of business model do you envision will match with your goals for your lifestyle business? What kind of life do you want to have? What kind of time do you want to spend on your business? And what kind of revenue do you want? Before you can decide on your business model, you have to decide on what you want your lifestyle business to be in terms of your goals and your vision for your business and for your lifestyle. It's very important to be able to fit in your family and your lifestyle together with your business. So the business model should work for your lifestyle. You don't make your lifestyle fit the business model, because basically that business model is probably not the one for you if you can't fit it into your lifestyle. So I have a Strategy Sunday a worksheet you can use to look at your goals and vision for your life and the legacy that you want to leave. And it is at jgtips.com/ssunday. And you can figure out your 5-year, 3-year, and 1-year goal for your business, your family, your life, and what kind of monetary goals that you'd like. And that will help to get you some clarity on maybe what kind of business model you would like to try. But for those of you, of course, who are already deciding what the business plan that you would like to try, I have an offer for you on to plan your business at jgtips.com/plan. And basically we have a look at what is a business plan and why do you need one, and how to pick your online business model, how to conduct your market research to see if it's viable for your online business, and how to define your unique selling proposition for your business, write up your elevator speech based on your USP and your short-term and your long-term business goals, how to develop your sales and marketing plan for your online business, and the obstacles to face and resources you need to meet your business goals, and how to implement your business plan, and how to determine if it's profitable, of course, And of course, you need to be able to know how to estimate your future revenue. And from that, you would create a business plan that you could either approach a bank or you could approach family or friends for money if you need it. Or you could decide not to do that business if you don't think it's viable once you've done the research, et cetera, et cetera. So I have a workshop offer over at jgtips.com/plan. And you're welcome to go and have a look. It's an earlier bird adopter offer for the founding members of it. And I hope to see you on that course in August, or even earlier if we get enough interest. So let's go back and look. Next week, we'll be looking at the components of a business plan and on a simple basis, an outline. After that, we'll look at them in detail. Should be able to finish that off by September. So to catch up with the Strategy Sunday trainings, go to Solopreneur Success Strategies playlist on my YouTube channel at http://jgtips.com/YouTube. Poof. That was a lot, I know. But of course, as you know, I'm on YouTube, so you can just go back and look at the show again if you want to have a look at the outline and figure out some of the things you need to do. Now, of course, you can always go to my website at jgtips.com/ssunday. We'll get you to the current episode of Strategy Sunday, so you can go over it again. And I hope that you found this useful, and I will talk to you again on Strategy Sunday on Solopreneur Success Strategies next week. We'll be looking at the components of a business plan. Thank you. Welcome to Solopreneur Success Strategies, where we talk about the entrepreneurial mindset and how to get your message out to your customers. How to know what your customer wants and how to make them your raving fans, as well as the knowledge and skills you need as an entrepreneur to save you time, money, and be more productive in your business. So welcome. Well, thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoyed and got some value out of our Solopreneur Success Strategies podcast today. And if you'd like to learn more about me, you can go over to jane-gardner.com/SSS, or please leave a review or just come and check me out. That would be great. Come and say hi at jane-gardner.com/SSS. I also have a TV show you're welcome to listen to as well over there. Thank you. Well, thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoyed and got some value out of our Solopreneur Success Strategies podcast today. And if you'd like to learn more about me, you can go over to jane-gardner.com/SSS, or please leave a review or just come and check me out. That would be great. Come and say hi at jane-gardner.com/SSS. I also have a TV show you're welcome to listen to as well over there. Thank you.